to your stations! Every bell spent treading water puts another league between us and the galleon.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine. Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Brandelar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back. Cheerio! Oh, yeah. Keep up, my boy.
Well, we can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it.
Oh, damn.
Rig of mercy. What have I done?
My lord.
That potion girl is everywhere. Why is she everywhere? Sheesh, that water. Damn.
There's a lot of sea between here and Walud, but any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take him forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehear.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I see we do as she tells.
What now?
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours.
That was quick.
Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Do you feel that, Jill?
All hands! Battle stations! Let's see what this girl can do.
So does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold.
Damn, dude.
But then, there is naught my blade cannot sever.
Never.
I'll find her.
Bloody hell.
Okay, interesting. Through the maelstrom.
Where did you hide her, Barnabas?
It's cool that they're out there.
Thank you.
Jesus. How the hell that thing still flow? Fuck out of that goddamn way. Check if there's any treasure chests. There's an item over here. Did I go down there? Could go in there too. Earth and Fury? 13.4. Jesus.
What the hell are you?
You came.
Get back.
Clive, how did you?
I'll explain later. Hands. Can you walk?
Out of here, I can.
Stand still!
Phoenix, are you not the dominant of fire?
I see naught before me but a guttering flame.
Jesus. Sheesh. That's not good.
To where?
You. What did you do to Joshua?
Phoenix? Oh, I expect he will survive. This consciousness in which you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black. And all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake.
Not if we remove the cause of this misery. Not if we destroy the last of the mother crystals and restore balance to the world.
Come, do you truly think it's so simple? The blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Naught, that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord.
Keep it. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice.
Ever led astray by your blind resolve.
Now, it is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate. However much it may hurt.
Get as far away as you can.
Clive. No.
Trust me, Jill.
So soon.
Never.
Clive!
Do you not see? Your iron will weighs you down, dragging you ever further from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos. Who are we? What are the dominants? The breath of the Creator still warm on our lips. We carry his light that we might guide the masses in his name. We are but mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you. The power we wield is his. And yet, every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being. It breaks us. It unmakes us. That its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The Icon. It is too much for even his chosen few. Apart from you, Mythos. You wield the might of many, yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that we dominants are a means to an end. We were created for you, that you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose.
We wishes?
To feed. As you would know, could you only look beyond the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of volition shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, and shall see them restored to their proper forms.
And what exactly would that be?
Why, loyal servants to God? No.
Manners, Lord Rossfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn everyone Akashic?
Not turn, Mythos. Turn back. For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills. It is time they return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation? And abandon everything we hold dear?
We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms. Not yours, and not your gods.
With every defiant expression of your will, the tighter the chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use.
Clive!
The faster it binds you to the remaining dominance, the stronger your hunger will become.
Until it leads you back to the only answer there ever was. Mayhap not by the path my master intended, but back all the same.
Ash is not far. I could freeze a path.
You're in no fit state.
Probably not, but I can try. Don't look back!
What? Clive bested?
The others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Jill. And they will have seen the ice where it led. We need only wait till dawn. This is the second time Barnabas has bested me.
Okay.
I'm powerless against him.
And maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master. Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? But do you really know me? If what Barnabas said was true, then... I'm more monster than man. It's time I summon the flames from within. I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for. Of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so low. Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving, provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
This is what you want, then.
Don't worry, Clive. It is. This burden, I'll give you the strength to bear it alone.
But I'm not alone. I carry my sins, my pain, my sorrow. I see now that they are all a part of me. might one day look upon the moon again, together.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I know. I never thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
Finally. Took you long enough.
What of Barnabas? Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough. Whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last mother crystal.
The Einherjar is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her. But they know we're coming now. We'll need a plan. And a damn good one at that.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Mid says Odin split the sea in two. She's always been partial to a tall tale. But there's tall, and then there's tall.
I struggle to believe it myself.
I see your uncle isn't with you.
He stayed with the Enterprise. After our brush with the Einherjar, she was in urgent need of repair. And my uncle knows a shipwright in Randalar. We're to join him there when we're ready to sail for Ash.
You sure that's wise? Last I heard, the place was still overrun with a Kashyyyk.
Show me a city where that isn't true. Ultima's plague is spreading.
We're running out of time, aren't we? We've done our best to shore up the hideaway. But I doubt a few planks will stop what's coming. Still, we'll keep at it. Every little helps, I suppose.
Let's hope so.
Oh, man. Ice Age. Oh, that's cool.
I should visit Joshua. assuming Talia will allow it.
Hold to increase potency. Uses permafrost. Wait. Releasing the button when the markers in the red zone maximizes width and knockback, also adding freeze effect to the ice. Okay. Dodge use an assigned to execute a powerful follow-up attack called Frostbite. Oh, okay. Let me strike with Frostbite. Frostbite will be temporarily frozen. Fancy dodging an attack will freeze all enemies within a radius. Okay. Oh, wow, that's cool. Can be used in mid-air. When using the enemies are pulled directly beneath Clive. Ooh. Can also be used in midair. Will not disturb enemies in front of Clive. What the heck? That's interesting. Enemy comes in contact with the crystal, be drawn inside and suffer continuous damage until it subsides. Crystal can only draw in smaller, lighter enemies. Pressing the execute button after the crystal has been sent will cause it to dissipate and replace another. Okay. Jesus. Increases the number of blast busts to 2 and increases hits for each blast. Okay, well, I like Cold Snap. Let's just unlock everything. Guess. Might as well. And upgrade whatever I feel like. Damn, dude, I don't. That's such cool art in the background for her. It's really cool. Only costs 1,000 to master ignition. It's kind of surprising, to be honest. This is the upgrade Ice Age. Five star stagger. That is a lot of stagger. I could technically also master Giga Flare, technically. Wait, did I? Oh, I thought it was hovering over now every time. I'm silly. That could technically master Giga Flare and swap off of Bahamut. I have to just get rid of some stuff. How much does this cost? 2,000? 3,000. 3,000 points. Uh, I could upgrade those moves though. So ridiculous that I can have Gigaflare anywhere now. And I do have another special dodge if I have Shiva.
I keep hitting
back too many times. I should upgrade the Cold's Net when I can. Upgrading Ice Age would be nice. What do I have equipped? Do I have Ice Age equipped? I do. I'll just do this for now.
Joshua.
Better than I was.
But not nearly as well as you should be. Your cuts and burns may have healed, but your body still bears the burden of every spell cast.
Then what would you have had me do? It was no ordinary foe we faced. It was the Warden of Darkness. Yet still, it was not enough. The King could have ended me at any moment, but instead chose to toy with me like a curl does a mouse.
You underestimate yourself.
Oh, it was crystal clear. Only one man established his dominance that day, and that man was Barnabas. I'm sorry, brother. That was ill-spoken. It's just, I have never felt so powerless. And when so many are looking to us for strength, perhaps the prince feels the same.
What is this place?
Don't move! It's fresh from the well. Grandmother told me spirits sometimes get lost, and that the lanterns guide them to their proper place. I set one on the river for her when she passed away.
fiend works from the shadows. Was it you who guided my hand then, Ultima? No, not you. This is my doing, my fault, my sin to bear. And for it, I must atone.
Your hurts are healing nicely. It was my poultices that saw you well.
You make them?
And sell them, or try to. Earns me enough for bread, most days.
Forgive me. I have nothing to...
I know, but I couldn't just leave you lying there. You're going then?
Of course. I'm healed. Thanks to you and your poultices.
Will you promise to come back and visit?
Phoenix, it would seem that I owe you my wings.
Perhaps he can find an answer. You will be returning to Walud soon, I gather.
I see no reason to wait.
Then neither do I.
I can think of a few. But I doubt they'll stop you. You will take your medicine.
Of course, Lady Tyre.
Set on leaving already, are you?
How long will it take us to get back to Ash?
Dunno, about the same amount of time it took us to get here. Maybe less, if your uncle can find someone trustworthy to patch up the Enterprise. All depends on where we're putting into port, mind.
Yes. It's not as if we can put ashore wherever we choose. We have to assume that the whole of Ash is hostile. And that we'll be attacked on sight.
Then we must find a place they won't think to look. And I have an idea who might know of one.
The Professor! I'll go and tell you, come in!
While you're plotting our course, I'll be in the shelves with your lawsman. I wish to pick his brains about Ultima.
Then I'll talk to Karen about supplies for the journey. They may not be easy to come by in Ash.
Your brother's body won't take much more of this recklessness. You know that, don't you?
I do.
Two new, side quests that have new, new unlocks.
Heard the bad news then, did you?
What bad news?
About Dravosht. Blackthorn's old haunt.
Uh-oh.
With the forge and all that. Well, anyway, the mines just down the road from there are spewing out ether like no one's business.
And the village?
Safe from the flood for now, but they've got other problems. Akashic. Every creature in the area is either turned, or on the way to turning, apparently. Zoltan and the others are living on borrowed time. They need help, and quick. Doris sent a few curse breakers to keep an eye on things, but there's only so much a couple of scouts can do. Except get eaten. If something ain't done soon, the old place will be overrun.
I won't let that happen.
Didn't think you would.
Does Blackthorn know?
I thought it might be better if he didn't. He'd only do something stupid. You reckon we should tell him?
No. It's better this way.
Yeah, well, I can't stand about knowing what's happening out there, so I'm off. I'll see you in Dravosht.
How was she? The Enterprise, I mean.
Ah, Sid. Just the man I was hoping to see.
Here we go again.
Did you have a mo?
Don't tell me. You need more bomb ash.
Oh, no. We still got plenty of that left. I'm working on bringing another one of Lachiev's designs to life. This time, it's a new smelter. It's got a reverberatory hood over the top for additional thermo amplification and a system of reciprocal recirculatory regenerators that let's just say it gets very blimmin' hot. A heck of a lot hotter than anything Blackthorn's got in his forge, that's for certain. Only mithril engines get hotter, and you can't chuck ore in one of them and get metal out the other end. Trouble is, we won't be able to make out of any old rubbish neither. We need the good stuff. And I hear you once helped Helena get her hands on exactly that. Any chance you could help me too?
If it's for the good of the hideaway, I'd be happy to.
Oh, it is. I promise you.
So, what exactly is this good stuff you need me to find?
We've got a couple of examples here. Spherical echoes, we call them.
More fallen materials. So this smelter is similar to the mithril engine in more ways than one.
That's right. They're a bit like the thermal helms. Fallen ceramics deal with heat like nothing else, see? And what's more, they're directional, transferring heat from the inside to the outside. But these things, they're all outside. If we line the hood with them, they'll reflect the heat right back into the furnace. We've collected as many as we can. And I know where we can get the rest. Trouble is, they're all watched over by their bigger, uglier cousins.
So you want me to visit some ruins, destroy some echoes, and bring back the spheres they're guarding?
That's it in a nutshell. Yeah, we're only 3 short, mind. And we know exactly where they are. There's one up Amberway, in that ruin that they call Lost Plume, and another in the Silent South, over in Dalmechia. Last one is in the ruins of Advent, which is in the Empire.
All right, then. Wish me luck.
It'll do. I'll be keeping all my fingers and toes crossed.
Weirder science.
With Canvert in...
There is another quest.
Hands of Akashic. I need to find another port.
Since that's on the way... I'll go this way. I'll go talk to the NPC for any other side quests in other cities, since that is on the way to the other one. My quarters.
How are you doing? Quick look.
Sandbrek has a side quest. Rosaria. Oh my god.
Seen enough?
Sheesh. Okay.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lock.
Come back. Oh, the stew's awfully thin these days.
You're helping me guide my mentor free from his immortal coil. Right away, what the madding crowd believes, physicians are not without our limits. I hope to cure every ill, mend every wound, save every life. My medicine that will see you home safe without fail is prevention. Not that this knowledge will ever stop any of you from chasing down some behemoth for his toenails. Okay.
There's no way of knowing if Doris will confide in me, but I can speak to her at least.
The one crystal left needs cracking. 1 minute, who can do it? See that you don't. That's the plan. What's new here?
Sangfornian deer.
Ooh.
It'd last you a good while.
Still gotta get that stone tongue and the stained loincloth.
We've run out of Papio nuts and all.
Still alive, are you? If you're gonna buy some, be quick about it. You'll not find a better price than that.
Is that all?
Can I help you, Sid?
I'm looking for Doris. Is she here?
I'm afraid not. She's at Martha's Rest on a job. My job, actually. When she heard what the mission was, she insisted on going herself. Alone.
Did she? What was the mission?
Following up on some new information. Once they'd settled in, the bearers you helped liberate in the Dragon's Eyrie were keen to talk about their imprisonment. And about their captor.
The slaver Cole's team were tracking when they were attacked by the beastmen. I'll go and find her. She's at Martha's Rest, you say?
If she's not moved on already, yes. I hope everything's all right.
Why would Doris insist on going alone? Maybe Cole was right to be worried.
Oh. Oh boy. Oh god. There's a lot of icons. There's a side quest all over there. All right.